सो फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू येट अनदर वीडियो ऑफ लाइफ कोच एंड इन दिस स्पेशल वीडियो स्पेशल एडिशन ऑन टुडे ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ वर्ल्ड मेंटल हेल्थ डे वी ऑल आर टुगेदर टुडे टू इरेज द स्टिग्मा अराउंड मेंटल हेल्थ काउंसलिंग एंड वेर एवर यू रिक्वायर हेल्प इन एरियाज ऑफ योर लाइफ. सो टुडे वी हैव अ पैनलिस्ट हियर हु आर टॉप साइकोलॉजिस्ट फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड दे आर गोइंग टू शेयर देयर विजडम विद यू आंसर योर क्वेश्चंस about life, relationships, mental health, and a lot more. So let's very quickly welcome our panelists. So our first panelist is Dr. Neha Jain. She's a psychologist, counselor, and UPSC faculty. We welcome you, Dr. Neha Jain. Very quickly, second panelist is Ms. Sasmita Patro. She's a counselor, life skills trainer, positive psychology certified. Welcome, Ms. Sasmita. Our third panelist is Ms. Jyoti Sapru. She is a psychological counselor with West Bengal Police. We welcome you, Jyoti. So
thank you, sir.
Yes. So and one more of our panelists, Mr. Sunil, who is also a psychological counselor, will join us very soon. So let's start this session. So there are around 16 people online with me on my chat room, and we will first take their questions before other people join here. Okay, should we start our process?
Yes. Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So people who find the question relevant to them, okay, they can raise their hand or they can answer the question. Okay, whoever feels it's relevant to them. Okay, the first question we have from, okay, yes, she's online with us. She's Miss Payal from Mumbai. She is a mother of a 10-year-old girl. And she is asking, what is obsessive compulsive disorder? Okay, why do kids get obsessed with their looks, and how to deal with kids getting obsessed with their looks? This is with respect to her 10-year-old girl.
Sir, is she asking somebody in particular, or do we all answer? How
anyone,
do we answer?
Anyone can come in and answer, then we can have that rotation of questions.
Okay. Sir, I think it's very important for her to understand that what is obsessive compulsive disorder, or उन्होंने कैसे decide किया कि बच्चे को OCD है. I mean, how has she got some tests done, or how does she diagnose in the first place that it is an OCD? Because OCD is basically having a tendency for excessive orderliness and perfectionism. And there is great attention being put to each and every small detail by the child. So is the child actually an OCD or not? First, we have to clarify that with the mother. Right. And I think aajkal ke bachcho mein jo ye itna zyada OCD is happening, it is mostly because of peer pressure and that they are exposed or overexposed to media. And, you know, there's too much of competition to look good, to be perfect in studies, to be very good in extracurricular. So I feel somewhere down the line, the parents should stop putting pressure on the child and let them be, you know, let them just spoil the room, let them paint the walls, let them paint the floor. We should not ask them to be orderly all the time. So it's always the parents who have to make an effort.
Right, right. So let us also get Dr. Neha Jain on board. So I wanted to ask, when students and children, they are with their peers, they are with their friends, and then they feel that need to groom themselves or look good or be like someone else. Okay, how can someone find where to draw the line? Where it's that in that safe line, normal, or when it becomes like a compulsion. So unable to, okay, let me, cannot hear Dr. Neha.
No, ma'am, we can't hear you.
Little louder.
Just a second.
Now we can hear you, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So what I was saying is See, whenever we talk about children, the parents are the first checker, or we can say that the first observer. So this line should be drawn, or the children should be made understand that how to draw these lines by the parents itself, and how they can keep a silent check on it. And every time, instead of just instructing a child that if your friend is doing this, this is not right, but not leaving up to this, that this is not right and this is not, it is good and it is not good. One should even explain the reason that why is it not good. For example, let me explain a case that I had in counseling earlier. He was a student of 12th standard. And just because of in Mumbai, there are it is a case of same as Mumbai only. And in Mumbai, in 12th standard, there is a college system. Students used to go to college. So what happened with this girl? She had a boyfriend, and after getting into relationship and all, now she broke up. And now what she said was, my each and every friend has a boyfriend, so even I just made a boyfriend. So parents can use such examples, because now these examples are very common. They can even, matlab, they should tell their children that, see, this is good, and agar aap ye karte ho, to iske baad ye 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 circumstances hote hain, and these are the real examples from your life. If though this much of friendly environment and open environment the parents create with the child, then I don't think so that it would be that much difficult for them to so ye itni badi badi bimari hai, if we call it OCD or we call it anxiety, which in these, especially in corona periods, it's a student are getting very much anxious, or they are saying hame OCD ho raha. Many cases are coming of OCD. Why is it so? Because parents are actually not open up with their children. They don't know the way to talk with their children. We very simply say, ye mat karo, ye theek nahi hai, as ma'am already said. We never open the room for the children. Let them explore, but at the same time, always keep a silent check. And when you keep that silent check on the child, and if we find somewhere, yes, the child is wrong, always try to go and discuss it with the child. Aap apne unke upar dalo mat. No, you should not do this. No. Why you should not do this? Let them make their decision on their own. Okay, if I'm going to do this, this circumstances is going to happen. I'm also going to face this thing, what my friend is facing, or what my neighbor person is facing, or someone other is facing. Let them think, let them analyze, because then only they are going to understand what is going. That's it. Thank you.
So we would conclude that it's good to have a friendly talk with them, heart to heart talk, where you can
exactly heart to heart talk. Many a times parents, what they do is, when we talk about no friendly talk, they very much misguide with this friendly talk. They actually don't know how to make the boundaries. So it is very much that heart to heart talk with boundary. But children should know that whom are we talking to are our parents, and they are talking to us with their own experiences and what they have seen in the outer world. So a parent should learn how to talk to the child.
Right, right. We'll move on to the next question, because there are a lot of people. I have already got around 7 questions till now. Next is, okay, my daughter is a teenager. She behaves somewhat rudely at times. She was kind of answering me back when I did not allow her to go to party with her friends, as it was late night party. I told her that I am not going to listen to her. She was still telling me that how unfair I am, and I am not like other people's moms. And I also took her laptop and iPod for 2 days as a punishment. I am very keen about disciplining them, but at the same time, I do not want to have that disconnect with them so that they stop liking me. She is like Miss Anjali from Pune, a mother of 15-year-old. I would ask like Sasmita to get into this.
Okay, so as she told that, yeah, she was trying to make the daughter discipline. How how Dr. Neha ma'am has told that, yes, while you are disciplining, it is not the old school of discipline, but we need to explain to the child what are the boundaries. So when you say no, you don't go, please explain why you shouldn't go. Yes. And what are the consequences, good and bad. Let them take the decision. Explain to the child, just how ma'am said that you have to draw the boundary. Let them take the decisions after you say what are the consequences, pros and cons. And as you said, yes, how can I connect? while doing the discipline. Do the discipline, but let the child feel that, yes, you are a person who understands. Tell them that, yes, anger that you're having is okay. Back answering what she's doing is not okay every time. But sometimes what happens, we also behave as parents in the house with our spouse, with our in-laws, with our parents like that. And children learn the behavior. The same thing we expect it from them, whereas we are behaving sometimes like that. So it is like we have to introspect our behavior. And we have to try to be friendly with them. And while disciplining, we need to just let them understand the pros and cons of everything. Why I'm stopping you from doing this. This is what is my input for this.
So better way would be to rationally and logically make them explain them things.
Yes.
Okay. Next is for you, Jyoti. The question is, he is a father of a 10-year-old boy, Mr. Arun. He asked that my son, whenever he gets stressed out during studies, he usually goes to computer games and video games. He says that it relieves his stress. When he starts playing video games, he asks for like maybe 20-30 minutes of a relaxation period, but that goes up to 2-3 hours. And now he is getting addicted to video games. How should I discipline him and create boundaries so that I can give him his stress-free mechanism also, but not get him addicted to this behavior? Ms. Jyoti.
Yes, sir. Actually, we have been getting a lot of cases where the screen time, you know, the time that the children are spending on their laptops and their mobiles is really gone up. So, sir, the child is how old, you said?
10 years.
10 years. So he's still very young. And at this age, now that the lockdown is not there, I think he should be promoted in playing a lot of outdoor games and activities where the parents have to work a little harder and be with him, take him out. And, you know, kind of they have to slice his breaks into longer periods. Like if he's too much on the phone, you tell him to take a break for 10 minutes, then you tell him to take a break for half an hour, then you tell him to take a break for 1 hour. So the slicing becomes more and the screen time becomes less. And more of outdoor activity can be done. You can also trade it for watching TV sometimes, or he can, you know, go on a complete digital detox if he is into reading, writing, or pick up a new hobby. They can adopt a pet, you know, having a pet. And It's just, you know, that he needs to slip away slowly. It has to be weaned off. And the phone should be made in such a way. I don't know if he has a phone at this age, he's too young. But if he could just use the phone for making calls and not any kind of social media, because that has been a big problem in the lockdown where children have taken to wrong habits on social media. So walking, jogging, even spot jogging, playing Ludo, Carom, anything, any activity where the parent is also involved with the child and the child gets some respite from his screen time.
Okay. So it would be like if parents become a part of these activities and also involve themselves, then it can create a good example. Okay, I think answers, Dr. Jyoti has also answered one more query. How do you encourage your child to stay physically fit? What are some of the activities you involve your child in to keep him healthy? Mr. Rahul, father of 7-year-old boy. So I think best way will be...
Very young.
Yes, very young. So still they can involve themselves with playing outdoors.
Outdoor games, activities. And in case there's a lockdown and they can't go out, they can do singing classes, dance classes, all online is now, everything is available. And make some physical activity out of it and not just sit in front of their laptops and phones all the time.
So one important point Ms. Jyoti has highlighted, that if the screen time is more, keep the screen time same, but you can even replace the screen time with maybe online activities. Even it's on screen time, it could be something healthier option where they can learn something.
One activity which has worked wonderfully with small children is you know, making some recipe. They have started taking up to cooking. They love to like make some breakfast or do something small in the kitchen. You know, just in the daily routine activities, aapko unko involve karna hi hoga. Otherwise, they, whenever they get bored, they find some solace with their phones and laptops.
Perfect, perfect. Next question for Dr. Neha. Should parents say sorry to their kids? Okay, when should parents say sorry to their kids? How does saying sorry to kids help the kids? I should, how saying sorry should help the kids? Okay, I find it very difficult at times to acknowledge my mistake in the entire event. How can I accept my mistake and say sorry?
See, we always say that parents always, themselves always are a mirror for their children. If you yourself cannot say sorry, your children will never learn to say sorry, first of all. Whosoever is this person is my message to him. So learn to say sorry, and you should always know where you are right. And whenever you are trying to say sorry, always give a justiciable, you should be always, the child should know, okay, here he is wrong, you are right over here, that's why I'm saying sorry to you. With a reason, okay, you are right, you are saying this thing right, you are right over here, your this decision or your this reason for doing this was right. Whenever you say this with the conclusion or with some explanation, you should always give this thing to child. And you say how to do this, I think it is something very easy, because here you don't have to do this to show someone or you really want to feel guilty. We are doing this here because we want our children to learn this. So when we want our children to learn this, we should start it day by day. Okay, aaj ye mistake ho gaya. I'm sorry, I have done this thing wrong. I'm sorry, I have done this thing wrong. So it is a gradual thing. It is not that big. And if you are feeling that much guilt inside yourself, discuss it with your partner. And you should together come to a solution, and then you should try to say sorry to your child.
Okay, this person has also added that, does saying sorry take away the dominance from a parent? Does it take away the control?
No, it never. How could you take a control? Because you also know that this is something wrong which you have done. So that's why you are saying sorry to that child. For example, if my child has done something wrong, and if I punish him for saying that, okay, you are not going to do this, I'm not going to give you that. So there is a reason behind that. You have done this thing wrong, that's why I have not given you that. At that time, you never need to say sorry to a child, because it will be an advantage. It is important that you should know where you have to say sorry to a child. Many a time it happens that we generally simply scold our children and then we feel bad. Maine usko daat diya, mujhe aisa nahi bolna chahiye tha. I should not say that much harshly to my child. It is not so. Agar that means you are not able to control your tempers. आप कुछ भी बोल देते हो एंड देन यू फील सॉरी कि ओके इट वाज नॉट दैट बिग मिस्टेक एंड आई हैव डन एंड आई हैव स्कोल्डेड माय चाइल्ड सो बैडली इट माइट बी लाइक दैट काइंड ऑफ केस व्हेन यू डोंट नो हाउ टू हैंडल योर योर एंगर सो इन सच केस इफ यू आर फीलिंग सॉरी दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू से सॉरी टू योर चाइल्ड एंड सम गिल्ट कॉन्शियस इज देयर इनसाइड यू सो यू शुड नो हाउ टू हैंडल योर एंगर सो दैट यू शुड नो व्हाट एट व्हाट डिग्री यू शुड show your anger to your child, or you should scold him, or you should say him something. And in some cases, many a times it happens, talk to your child like this simply. Okay, this is my mistake. I'm sorry for this thing. I should not have done this thing like this. It should not be that saying sorry to a child never means that you should feel very much guilt. You should show that I'm feeling very much guilt. It should be a healthy talk. Okay, मेरे को ऐसा नहीं बोलना चाहिए था. आई एम सॉरी, मुझे इतना गुस्सा नहीं होना चाहिए था, मैं धीरे भी बात कर सकता था, नेक्स्ट टाइम से आई विल नॉट डू दिस. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ सिंपल टॉक्स मींस दैट चाइल्ड फील्स ओके इफ दे हैव स्कोल्डेड इट सो मच देन ऑल्सो दे आर फीलिंग दैट दे शुड हैव नॉट डन दिस थिंग सो इट्स ओके द चाइल्ड अंडरस्टैंड्स.
यस, वेरी नाइसली एक्सप्लेन डॉक्टर नेहा. So the next question we take would be for us. Okay, Susmita. Okay, this is from Mr. Jitendra, who is with us in this Zoom meeting also. He says that recently his close friend's sister, she passed away. and how can he talk with his friend so that he will be able to comfort his friend and be, help him to get out of this grief?
Okay, so this grief...
Slightly louder, Ms. Asmita.
Okay, so are you able to hear me now?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so this loss of your loved one, while we are grieving for that, it takes little time for the loved ones to come out of this. When we are talking to the friend, we have to say yes, we can understand, because it will take some time. But at the same time, while showing the sympathy, we have to empathize, only saying that, see, if we focus only on what we cannot change, we cannot move on. So it is difficult, it is hard, but you have to also move on. And because you have to help the other person as well. Because if we are not strong, how can we help the other person? How can we give the hand, helping hand, for the sister to come up? So I'm not saying instantly it will happen, because I'm also handling so many corona death cases, and counselees are coming crying. So I tell them, yes, it will take some time, because you have not even could hold them, or you cannot cry over them, you cannot meet them. So it is not so easy. So the space we have to give, as well as more sympathy, less empathy, but empathy we have to tell that, yes, whatever happened, happened. But we have to be strong so that we can make the other person stronger.
So you mean to say more of reflective communication, reflecting on what they feel?
Yes, yes, how they feel. Also listen to all the feelings, tell them how you are feeling, what you are feeling, and tell that friend to ask the sister as well. Let her vent out her feelings, her emotions. Let her cry out. So sometimes what is happening is, see, just now recently I had a case where the client has come and told that her sister has lost her husband, and she was also very critically ill. The daughter was only 19 years old. She never knew anything. They have spent 20 lakhs. Now they are into zero. Okay, so what happened is, this mother, means that sister, is now having the, after corona, it takes nearly 1 month to recover. So you will have this fluctuation of oxygen level. Okay,
yes.
So what are the fears she is having is, she couldn't cry for her husband's death. She is having fear that if I will have corona again, then I don't have the money even to go to the hospital for the treatment. She has the fear, how will this daughter will cope up with all this, and she is not able to cry. So the client told, I want my sister to come and come for counseling. So I told, sir, just give some time. After 15-20 days, once she's physically a little bit recovered, then we can talk to her. Because she's not able to cry, and she's telling to the brother, I'm not able to cry because I have a lot of fears. So I told, okay, the fears are not irrelevant, what she's feeling, because she's not physically fit also. So it takes time for the client also to recover. So just, you have to listen to all the feelings and emotions, and just listening will allow them to also heal. Somebody is listening without interrupting.
Okay, Sasmita, just in a minute, okay, I would like you to give a piece of advice for people, because you told about COVID, okay, who have already had COVID, they were severe, okay, maybe they were critically ill, and then they recovered. And now whenever they come across someone who is sneezing, coughing, or a person who could be a potential carrier, they get that phobia again, that if I were to again infect myself again, I don't want to go through all this. How can we comfort such a person and assure him that it's gone now? There are very less chances that you could catch this infection again. Just 30 to 40 seconds only, then we move on to the next question.
Okay, so how will you come out of that fear is, you just think how you came out of the critical situation. When we are rationalizing our feelings, then only we can move on. Otherwise, the same fear will be there. Because if I had gone through something, the fear will be there. So when the fear comes, when the anxiety comes, just rationalize it. Think, why am I feeling? And what will be the worst case scenario? What will I get? I will anyways go and get admitted and recover and come back. That is the last thing which can happen to me, right? So you have already recovered. So you should empower other person how they have recovered. So that one you can give one tip that, okay, see, you can be the one. Actually, I told my client that you are actually giving me tips. She has given me tips what she has done for the COVID time and how she has taken care of the kids, husband and all that. So I said, okay, I'm getting the clues how you are handling. So they can be actually the influence to empower others. So that you can put as a point.
Fine. Yes. So we could also add on some maybe facts or some figures of people getting reinfected with COVID and the chances of not getting, so that they can be doubly sure. Okay, we move on to the next question. This is for Jyoti ji. This is from a person who is on with us on this Zoom meeting, Miss Kalpana. Kalpana, what if a wife reads a husband's message without his knowledge and finds something suspicious? But husband gets angry and stops talking. Okay, now, so how should one deal with such a partner?
Yeah, hi Kalpana ji. This is a very common, I think, husband wife ke beech mein. This is something that we all deal with. But yes, definitely everybody has a right to their privacy. Everybody needs time. Everybody needs space. We must also accept that, you know, the entire life is not black and white. Lot of it is gray. And in case, you know, there is something that the husband wants to keep to himself, I think, you know, by adding a lot of humor and hasi mazak, saath mein utna, baithna, khelna, and tab aap check karein, he will not mind it. But in his absence, if you are breaching the privacy and spying on him, I think that is definitely not healthy for your relationship. And it will add to disharmony. Then he will check your phone in your absence, you know, and that's how the problems get aggravated. So, saath mein rahiye, milke rahiye, aur hasi mazak mein kabhi kabar check kar lijiyega. There's no need to do all this behind his back. That's what I would feel. I mean, he would definitely feel upset. Even I would feel upset if somebody would check my phone in my absence. It's everybody has a right to their privacy. So don't breach that.
So Jyoti, I want to also add one of my questions here. Okay. Related to this. So usually when partners check their other partner's phone and they find something suspicious, they give that reason that if there is nothing wrong or there is no mistake on your part, why are you hiding it? Okay. How should one counter answer such a claim?
Sir, here I would like to say that, you know, we have five sensation. But our perception is determined by our preconceived notions. ठीक है, तो अगर मुझे आप में कुछ गलत ढूंढना है तो मैं सही को भी पढ़ के उसको गलत इंटरप्रेट कर सकती हूँ. सो दिस इज अ वे ऑफ ओनली एडिंग कॉम्प्लिकेशंस, यू नो. So maybe you've just sent a good morning message to another lady friend. So the wife may not be that close with the lady friend and she feels offended. So it's just a simple good morning message, but that becomes such a big issue.
Right.
So I'm sure that, you know, we all know as adults, we are not children. And we know how to deal with our lives and we make sensible decisions and we are duty bound towards our families. So ye chota mota checking phones, checking wallets, checking bags, I think these are avoidable. And if the couple is completely bonded, like I said, that they are having a very good bonding, they are, you know, saath mein hasi mazak kar rahe hain, chalo yaar show me your phone, dikha diya, to us time you may not, you know, find it in a conflict. It's not a conflicting situation. But then if you are threatening and then you're saying, no, show me your phone, and there might be a simple message which you misinterpret according to your own thinking and your own mindset, which might aggravate and make a non-issue into a big problem.
Right. So keep it okay, like
Gurpreet ji, can I add
हाँ जरूर 30-40 seconds बहुत सारे questions आ गए अब तक
क्योंकि जैसे अभी now how ma'am has told that see now we all are locked up for long time so what is happening is sometimes we share our feelings we share our thoughts with our friends okay so what happens sometimes we share yeah I'm feeling frustrated I'm feeling tired So that doesn't mean something personal I'm sharing. Even we feel frustrated and we feel like, yaar, mujhe bahar jana hai. So when I'm saying that doesn't mean I'm not close to my husband, but I'm sharing it. As now work from home, most of the people are working from home and their working times are also not even 12 hours. It's more than that. So where will I vent out? And especially when it comes to see, I'm telling you the truth that my husband doesn't check my phone. Why? Because even if I tell, okay, check this, so he said no. Because you are a counselor, I don't want to go through any WhatsApp. Why should I go through this? So actually, agar aap aisa boundary kar doge, so you will not feel like okay, someone is checking, someone is not checking. So how I'm see now also you can tell with whom I'm talking. Why there is a man? Why there are so many men who are asking questions? Why that man is coming and sitting and talking? So all these are like perceptions, what man says. How I perceive the things.
Absolutely. I agree.
So I would sum up that let people have their vent out and their comfort zones and their punching bags or you could say whatever heals them, let them have that option with them, right?
Yes.
Okay, next is I think it's for Dr. Neha. Yes. Okay, there is a lady, Miss Kanika from Rajasthan, and she has recently delivered a baby, and it's around 1 month now. She says, I should be very happy with my baby, but I am feeling very low. I am not interested in anything. I even do not feel like tending to the baby. Okay, why is this? Okay, now also an extension of this question. Okay, this similar question by Miss Sonam from Chandigarh. Okay, my friend has scary thoughts regarding her baby. She has become psychotic. Okay, now like she has done this kind of judgment. She thinks that something bad will happen to her baby or she might harm the baby unknowingly. Okay. Due to this, she avoids taking care of her baby. Okay, this has created a difficult situation for her family. Okay, so abhi postpartum pe aa gaye hum.
See, whenever we are too much connected to someone, na, hame aise feelings tab bhi aate. This is a normal. We talk about a fear. In general, we always we can say that to whom we are very much caring or to whom we are very much connected, then this happens ki okay, thoda sa bhi kuch kar denge to kuch ho jayega. Generally, it happens with all new mothers. It happens. First of all, you have gone through 9 months of pregnancy. Then there is a COVID period. Then there is a 1.5 month of delivery period. So if you are feeling like very much low, not taking care of your baby, and actually not a finish when I was 2 months conceived, my husband left me. I think a message is there on the chat. Is this from this person?
No. This is like because we are having this conversation. It's all it's an add-on, but we'll answer that.
Okay. So it is like that. It happens. It is happening with that person because generally it happens with all the new mothers because now we are there with some new responsibility. And what happens is how much we do, we always feel like, nahi, this is not right. Ye karna chahiye, wo karna chahiye. Talking to so many people, unse pata chalta, achha, ye aise nahi karte. Toh we generalize ourselves. Okay, maine ye sahi nahi kiya. मैंने ये ठीक किया मैंने ये सही नहीं किया मैंने इससे पूछा मैंने उससे पूछा सो दिस इज द एनवायरमेंट वी क्रिएट फॉर आवरसेल्फ्स इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वी शुड ऑलवेज थिंक दैट बीइंग अ मदर कैन नेवर हार्म हर बेबी एंड वॉट एवर अ मदर डज इज वॉट एवर शी इज डूइंग इज देयर वॉट एवर शी हैज विथ हर सो एक माँ कभी भी अपने बच्चे का पहले तो बुरा नहीं करेगी और उसके पास जो होता है वो उससे बहुत ज्यादा अच्छा ही देती है अपने बच्चे के वी शुड ऑलवेज कीप्स आवर दिस सेल्फ दिस थिंग इन माइंड एंड नेवर क्वेश्चन आवरसेल्फ्स कि आई एम डूइंग दिस एंड आई एम डूइंग रॉन्ग. नो, अ लर्निंग ऑप्शन इज ऑलवेज ओपन, लर्निंग रूम इज ऑलवेज ओपन फॉर अस. अगर कुछ गलत हुआ है तो वी कैन लर्न इट, वी कैन एक्सप्लोर आवर वर्ल्ड एंड हम उसे वापस ठीक कर सकते हैं. देन आई थिंक देयर वाज वन मोर थिंग व्हेन शी सेड दैट अपने बेबी पे भी वो ध्यान नहीं दे रही है.
राइट राइट.
तो देयर माइट बी सम अदर कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस बिहाइंड इफ शी इज, देन देयर माइट बी समथिंग व्हिच इज डिस्टर्बिंग हर, दैट इज व्हाई शी इज नॉट एबल टू टेक केयर ऑफ हर चाइल्ड प्रॉपरली एंड इफ शी इज फीलिंग. सो दैट मींस देयर इज सम काइंड ऑफ इमोशनल स्ट्रेस व्हिच इज एक्चुअली डिस्टर्बिंग हर, वेयर शी शुड वर्क ऑन इट. So if she has opened it like this, so she should talk on the things which we are actually disturbing is maybe from other family environment or any other thing. So that might be the reason why she is distributed and she is not taking care of a child properly. Okay. Then there was one more question with another person. In this case, if the mother is not able to take care of the child and she is not able to concentrate with the child or take proper care, this might be just because there is definitely some stressful situations going in the family or personal with herself. That is the only which she is not able to cope up. And that is why there will, this reason must be there. But the second person who is feeling that she is not at all good for her child or not doing anything, not able to do anything, might be because she is obsessive with the child. Okay, you know, when we are over emotional, so we feel that, okay, I'm not doing this right, I'm not doing that right. It might be case of that. That's it.
Okay. तो ओके हम लोग आगे बढ़ते हैं. ये भी इससे कनेक्टेड क्वेश्चन ही है. ज्योति जी से आंसर करते वापस से टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट को ध्यान में रखते. ओके दिस इज फ्रॉम समवन हु वाज इन दिस ग्रुप. ओके आई एम नॉट गेटिंग स्लीप एट नाइट एट ऑल. आई एम हैविंग अ 10 मंथ्स ओल्ड बेबी. ओके ओके आई एम ऑर्फनेज. ओके सो मे बी ही और शी वांट्स टू से शी इज एन ऑर्फन. ओके व्हेन आई वाज 2 मंथ्स कंसीव. ओके ओके okay my husband left me from that time. okay yes okay I am leading my life myself, me and my baby at home. I don't know about my future. okay for this reason I am not getting sleep at all and I cry oftenly. what do I do for this? please suggest.
kisko ye sawal
hai? jyoti ji.
Yes, sir. Hi. Am I audible now?
Yes, yes.
Sir, actually, as we all know that this is postpartum depression. It's a form of depression. And can I know the name of the lady who's asking the question?
She had put Redmi as the name.
Okay. So whoever is this person in question, I would like to make it very clear to her ki this is not a very big abnormalcy. It is a very common problem और ये बहुत सारी ladies को होता है. And insomnia is a symptom. It is a part of it. And depression में you do feel low and you do cry. तो आपको you don't have to really worry so much कि मेरे को ये क्यों हो रहा है. ये होता है. It is a part. It is a process. It is a phase which will go away on its own. And it's very good that you are aware and you're recognizing your symptoms and you're voicing them. So aapko isko overcome karne mein zyada time nahi lagega. All that you need is a support group. You need some kind of talking therapy, somebody to talk to. If you do not have anybody in your family, we are all there for you. आपको कभी भी कोई ऐसी थॉट्स आती हैं, आप बात करना चाहती हैं, आप हमसे बात करिए. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव अ सपोर्ट ग्रुप एट दिस पॉइंट इन योर लाइफ. अदरवाइज देयर कैन बी चांसेस दैट दिस लीड्स टू मेजर डिप्रेशन लेटर ऑन. सो आपको ये समझ में आ रहा है, यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट यू आर हैविंग दिस. इस स्टेज पे इट इज नॉट अबनॉर्मल. इट हैपेंस टू 90% ऑफ द विमेन. दे गो थ्रू दिस. सो डोंट फील सैड अबाउट इट. यू विल कम आउट ऑफ इट एंड यू विल कम आउट ऑफ इट इन अ स्ट्रॉन्ग वे. जस्ट कीप टॉकिंग टू पीपल, बी पॉजिटिव एंड बी स्ट्रॉन्ग. थैंक यू.
Jyoti ji, in one sentence, can you give this person some insight about raising her child as a single mother, okay, and the uncertainty, the fear of uncertainty she is having with respect to what will be the future of the child, the financial part, all these things. Anything in one sentence would you like to give her?
Yes, I always believe and I say that it's all in our mind. Ye hum soch lete hain ki humko koi sahare ki zarurat hai. Do you think all the women who are married, who have a man in their life, are perfectly married and happily married and they are getting maximum support? Not necessary. We are all on our own respective journey. Yes. You have a child, that's a big support for you. Do not see it as a hurdle. Train your mind to be happy with whatever you are blessed with, and your life will be very successful. Do not go into negative thinking and do not try to indulge in self-pity. Try to be positive with your situation, with your blessings. You are safe. Corona mein, you've had a baby.
Yes.
The baby is safe. You're doing fine. आगे भी अच्छा होगा. हम जैसा सोचते हैं वैसा ही होता है. तो आप अच्छा सोचिए, आपके साथ जरूर अच्छा होगा. थैंक यू.
सो वाइंड अप, टू वाइंड अप, जस्ट हैव अ ग्रेटिट्यूड, बी थैंकफुल ऑफ व्हाटएवर यू हैव राइट नाउ.
यस, वी डेफिनेटली नीड टू प्रैक्टिस दिस, स्पेशली इन दिस मोमेंट्स ऑफ क्राइसिस. एंड आई डू हैव यू नो, आई एम्पथाइज विद दिस लेडी दैट यू नो शी फील्स लोनली एट टाइम्स एंड शी इज डिप्रेस्ड एंड शी इज नॉट स्लीपिंग, बट शी जस्ट नीड्स टू चेंज हर थिंकिंग. इट मे बी लिटिल डिफिकल्ट एट दिस टाइम, बट प्लीज रिलैक्स योरसेल्फ. आई कैन टेल यू वेज ऑफ डूइंग इट ऑल्सो. Like I said, get a support group, talk to people, you can practice yoga, do pranayam, do some kind of exercise that will calm your mind, calm your body, and I'm sure you will be fine. You just need to get out of this negative thinking. Thank you.
Right. Thank you so much. Agla question, Sasmita ji ke liye, from Ruchi, 39 age, from Mumbai. लिख रहे हो, माई हस्बैंड कॉल्स मी फैट ऑल द टाइम. ओके, आई इग्नोर इट इनिशियली, बट इट स्टार्टेड टू अफेक्ट माई सेल्फ एस्टीम एंड ग्रेजुअली आई एम डेवलपिंग वेरी नेगेटिव फीलिंग्स टुवर्ड्स हिम. आई एम ऑल्सो ट्राइंग वेरी हार्ड टू लूज माई वेट, बट बिकॉज ऑफ हिज कमेंट्स आई एम नॉट एबल टू कीप विद द डाइट एंड एक्सरसाइज रिजीम. व्हाट कैन आई डू?
ओके, सो आपने जो जैसे बोला कि सेल्फ एस्टीम मेरा अफेक्ट हुआ है, सो सी मैम, आई कैन से वन थिंग, पीपल मे फाइंड यू फैट, मेनी विल से यू आर थिन, कमेंट्स विल बी देयर ऑल द टाइम, बिकॉज एवरी स्टेजेस ऑफ लाइफ आइदर यू विल बी थिन और फैट और ब्लैक व्हाइट दिस दैट, व्हाई यू शुड बी लाइक दिस एंड ऑल. प्लीज आई एम नॉट सेइंग इग्नोरिंग इज इजी, यू शुड आस्क योरसेल्फ, is this what defines me? Is your fatness, is your color that is defining you? Your outside is what is defining you, or the inside that you have, the strength that you have, the intelligence that you have, the talents that you have defines you? Actually, that defines us.
Yes.
It is not with age and with our changing scenario. You cannot say we are the same before Corona and now. So we have all changed. Our mental health also, have so many times we go through, yeah, this is not good. But the positive self-talk, which has helped us still, for all of us, I'm saying, it's not only you or me or anybody. We all have, I'm so sorry. It's raining so heavily that I'm disturbed. So the self-positive talk, you have to say, okay, a determination about your own, taking care of your own body. Who is saying what should not define you and determine and break your confidence level and the discipline that you are doing for your mental health, physical health, anything. The discipline, I am doing it for myself. Think about yourself. When you only allow your husband to define you, that for my husband I am doing it. You are not doing anything for your husband. मैं मेरे पति के लिए नहीं कर रही हूँ, मैं खुद फिट एंड फाइन रहना चाहती हूँ, इसीलिए मैं कर रही हूँ. मैं खुद फिट एंड फाइन रहूंगी तब पति बच्चे सब कुछ बाद में आते हैं. So अगर आप ये सोचेंगे कि I am doing it for my self care, then you can do it with discipline. Not because your husband told or not because I said something. Nothing will work out unless until you think I am doing it for myself.
Right, right. So to conclude, take your husband's comments as a certain point of view, which has no authority at all. Okay, it's not a survey which you did about you, if you are fat or not fat, and people all around India commented that, okay, she's fat or not fat. It's a single person's comment in the entire world of crores of people. It should not matter to you. Okay, next question, Dr. Neha ke liye. Okay, I'll be clubbing up two questions. Okay. One is with relation to when should parents discuss sex with their children? What is the best way of approaching the topic of sex with children? How can parents make children comfortable while discussing this topic? This is Mr. Kapil, father of a 14-year-old boy. The next question also I would like to narrate, okay, because it's similar, okay. I am a college going girl. Okay, she has written her name anonymous. Okay, I am a college going girl. I travel by bus almost daily. Boys in bus touch, rub and press in my private parts. The bus is too crowded. But when someone good looking boy does it to me, I enjoy the touch. Okay, that encourages them to do it further. Is this wrong or is this natural? Is it okay to enjoy such rubs and presses? I feel little guilty, blood pleasure too. I'm so confused. So two questions similar.
See, when we talk about how to go for sex education with children, so you should very well know what is the age for it and what are the changes. See, for we say that teenage is the best age. But actually, in teenage also, many children don't go for such changes or the hormonal changes. When you observe those hormonal changes in your child, when you observe such shocks in your child, okay, when he is very much attracted towards opposite sex, or when he is talking about parties, and also you should not directly start with it. You should always first start with it, okay, now you are a boy, you are a matured person, or you are a girl, now you are getting matured. You have these much of limits. So our class should start with like this, with the basic part. Then later on, when these children grow up, we should, like, if I say that, definitely, mother is very much comfortable with a girl child and father is very much comfortable with a boy child. So later on, when they get maturity of what is a girl and what is a boy and how to handle this thing very much carefully, like, okay, kya ho gaya? They should not, agar when you both are friends, that doesn't mean that every relationship is that relationship. When the child is able to handle that thing very much properly, or then only one should go for such further discussions about sex education and all, until and unless if a child is getting involved in such kind of things. Like many a times it happens, we are coming to these cases, like children are going for like relationships and all, children have done in schools also, they have gone through all these things. If in child is going towards this kind of track, then it is very much necessary for a parent to take the child to a counselor or a psychologist, when a professional should talk to them on this place. But if everything is normal, so you should talk, you should start with a girl and a boy. Okay, you are a boy, this is your opposite sex, you are friends, you are classmate, now you are grown up, you should know how to maintain a safe distance with others, or you should know what type of talks you should go with them, or in your friend circle also, what types of talks are you sharing. So with these kind of things, we should start up with sex education with our child, so that we may know what is the maturity of our child. Many a times parents do, 15 saal ka ho gaya, ab to itni maturity ho gayi hai, 17 saal ka ho gaya, pata. You never know your child is ready for this. वो एकदम से सोचेगा, हाउ कम माय पेरेंट्स इज ऑल ऑफ अ सडन टॉकिंग टू मी इन ऑल दीस वे और ऑल सच, स्पेशली विद मेल बॉयज, नॉट विद फीमेल्स, बिकॉज़ इन फीमेल्स वी गो फॉर प्यूबर्टी चेंजेस, पीरियड्स एंड ऑल, एवरीथिंग इज हैपनिंग. सो फॉर अ केयरिंग थिंग, अ मदर ऑलवेज फॉर अ, आई शुड से दैट, एक सिक्योरिटी पार्ट के लिए मदर हमेशा बोलते हैं, यू शुड टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ नाउ, दिस कुड हैपन टू यू व्हेनेवर यू गो फॉर, व्हेनेवर वी स्टार्ट विद अ पीरियड्स. बट विद बॉयज दिस थिंग इज वेरी मच डिफरेंट. अंटिल एंड अनलेस this. You are feeling that your child is indulging in all such things. Take step by step things to educate your child with all these kind of things. Now, our second question was a college going girl who actually enjoys when a smart boy or a good looking boy is doing this. So this is, I think, something problem is going on with the girl, and where she needs an expert advice, and where she should even, we need to take some history of the girl from where she has started these kind of feelings that she's attracted towards a person who is good looking of opposite sex, or from where these kinds of thoughts are coming and what age these thoughts are coming. Because yes, this is very much wrong. Whether a good looking person or whether a bad looking person, if this thing is happening to you, you should avoid such situations or such things to happen to you. There should nothing be like that. I'm enjoying this thing and I'm not enjoying that. So this is something which is wrong to you. And if you are enjoying it, then you really need a help. And in help, we actually need to know, you can come to us, you can talk to us, where we actually need to know about what has happened to your past, or what were the situation when it started, when you started feeling like this. Then only we can actually come to some kind of help to you. Right now we can say this, yes, actually it is wrong and you should not go this. That's it.
And so many people, I think, when they have such an experience, they do not know that it is actually they are getting molested. But later on, when they actually realize that this happened with them, and at that time they were not able to voice their opinion or maybe stand up for themselves.
Exactly. Many a time it happens with girls. Chara nahi hai, rasta nahi hai, usi bus mein roz jana hai, majboori hai. But I think aap public mein apni voice raise nahi kar sakte ho, but you can take help from your family members. If you are feeling such thing and you are feeling bad, take some of your brother, your sister, anyone with you, so that you feel safe. Do ya teen din aap unke saath jaiye, thoda sa security aap, you go, try to go with your friends, try to take lift with your friends, manage your way like this. If you don't want to come in the limelight, if you don't want to say or create, avoid such things. How? To take some other kind of help with you. You cannot avoid jana roz hai, karna roz hai, to hame uska rasta nikalna padega. We cannot avoid such things.
Right. So Jyoti ji, sirf 30 seconds mein kuch isme add on karna aapko?
Haan sir, actually I was really surprised to hear this lady, because usually we get cases where the men are very comfortable with strangers touching them. It's not, you know, like women are always in danger. So I must warn her that she is inviting trouble for herself, and she may fall into deep trouble. So she must be very, very cautious. And like we know and we see in TV, so much is going wrong with women all over the world. So she must be very careful and try and not engage in such activities, because it can be harmful for her.
And please raise an alarm regarding this with your parents and someone in your college or school.
Absolutely. Such people should be actually punished, and they should be taken to task in public. You should raise hue and cry instead of, enjoying this activity. It is really bizarre. I mean, it's not normal. It's not normal. She needs help, definitely.
Right. Okay, for
can
you
I
only.
Add, I want to especially tell that girl that remember one thing, your body belongs to you. Unless until you want, and that is not like in public someone can use you, no. That is not why the body is meant for. See, this is called life, because I am a life skill trainer. I can tell you from the childhood, from 7th, we are giving the life skill training to the kids, so that you should know what others should touch, not any the private parts especially. So that is not what you should enjoy. And how ma'am, all of them have told, yes, you need help. Yes. Please take help so that you can be safe.
Some children also, because of childhood abuse, they get very soon, they get matured before age. That could be also some hidden reason here.
That is what only I'm feeling. Maybe she has exposed with something, some kind of thing. That's why she is enjoying that. But because this is a public platform, we cannot say. So better is you connect with either any of the panelists personally, so it can help you.
Right. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर ज्योति. ओके वन सेकेंड. यस ओके. आई हैव कॉट माई हस्बैंड चैटिंग टू हिज एक्स गर्लफ्रेंड ऑन अ कपल ऑफ ओकेशंस. ही टेल्स मी दैट आई हैव नथिंग टू फियर, इट्स जस्ट अ कैजुअल चैट विद हर. Now when I want to see what actually they were talking about, he does not let me see his phone. Now how should I trust him that this is harmless? Okay, it's a 36-year Anupama from Lucknow.
Okay, is she online with us, sir?
She is online in my chat, yes.
Okay, online in your chat.
Yes.
Sir, actually, like I just answered one of the questions before this, very similar, that is the husband acting in a responsible way at home? Is he fulfilling his duties as a husband? Is he fulfilling his duties as a father? Or is he being irresponsible? He's not giving her money. He is not being like, the husband is supposed to be the guardian for the wife. Is he fulfilling all his roles? If yes, then there is nothing to worry. He will maybe, you know, the ex always comes back and they do catch up, and then that phase goes away and then he is back with family. So there are only one way of judging that if the man is fulfilling all his duties and keeping his wife happy. Uske baad, if he's chatting with somebody who is his ex, there's no need to feel so insecure. And if definitely you are very insecure and you are feeling threatened by the presence of his ex, then you can definitely confront him and tell him that I am not feeling happy and I am not satisfied and I am feeling insecure. You must communicate, you must express your dissatisfaction. And in spite of that, if he continues, then it is something to be worried about. But I don't think that a harmless chat with somebody is a reason to, you know, kind of break up a marriage or go in for something more harmful. There are ways of communicating. हमेशा ये पाया गया है ऐसे केसेस में दैट देर इज अ लैक ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. द वाइफ इज सो बिजी विद द चिल्ड्रन, शी इज सो बिजी विद द हाउसहोल्ड वर्क, कि वो इमोशनली अपने हस्बैंड को कंपनी नहीं दे पाती है. इट इज नॉट जस्ट द फिजिकल एंड द मेंटल पार्ट, द इमोशनल कोशेंट सफर्स. सो देयर यू नो दैट वॉइड और द वैक्यूम दैट इज क्रिएटेड, इट माइट बी फिल्ड बाय a boyfriend or a girlfriend with somebody whom you can, you know, kind of vent out, you can talk, you can share. And we all need, you know, gossip. We have to talk about our wife. Oh, she doesn't do this, she doesn't do that. So it's just a harmless talk, you know, it's a vent, which is not very unhealthy. So there's nothing to be worried. But yes, अगर आपको उनसे प्रॉब्लम हो रही है, आप प्लीज कन्वे करिए. यू मस्ट कम्युनिकेट, यू मस्ट टेक एक्शन. एंड स्टिल इफ इट कंटिन्यूज, देन यू विल हैव टू, यू नो, इन्वॉल्व योर फैमिलीज और व्हाटएवर, और गो फॉर प्रोफेशनल हेल्प. थैंक यू.
राइट, थैंक यू. एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन, दिस इज फॉर सस्मिता. ओके, इट्स अ सिमिलर क्वेश्चन. ओके, दिस इज फ्रॉम Pooja, 32-year female from Bangalore. Okay, I started responding to flirtatious attempts made by my male colleagues when lockdown started. My husband was constantly busy with work, okay, and didn't have any time for me. So this was my sweet little indulgence. Okay, okay. But now that we have to get back to work, I am feeling terribly scared. I have started limiting chats with them, but I fear that they might come back to me, or my husband would read the chat history. And how do I handle this? Even there is some small amount of guilt.
Okay. What exactly happened is, you want to replace the emotional vacuum, or the, I can say, I cannot communicate with my husband because of the work from home and the schedule. So you try to replace it with that, and now you are feeling guilty. So I want to tell you one thing. See, please don't feel guilty about what happened in the past, because we cannot change anything in the past. Okay, so now how we will move on. Now only focus should be, how will you move on? See, the fear that you have to talk to them. How ma'am has told in the previous thing, Jyoti ma'am, same I'm telling you, please talk to them, communicate with them that, see, I have just engaged in these kind of talks because I was at home. Don't tell because my husband was not available or anything. Just tell that, yes, because I was working from home and I was stuck in home. So I just continued these kind of talk. But now, as I don't have time and I have to go, get back to my work and things are getting normal. So I don't have much time for all these things. And these are not the important thing in my life or in my schedule. And it is not going to take me, neither any of you, to any destination. Neither we can achieve anything through all this. So this is what is the advice I can say. But please don't have the guilt with you. Fear, with fear, if you are handling the situation, then it will be worst. So better is have a proper communication. That is called effective communication. How will I talk? So you don't have to say, because husband doesn't have the time, so I have spent the time with you. You just say, because I was at home, so I was getting time, so I just spent the time with you. So that is what I can say, effective communication. The previous question also, which madam has replied, Jyoti ma'am, so when you are telling about your husband, so how are you approaching? Is it like, just like a police, you are saying, what are you chatting with? No, this is not how we should address the our partners. How am I talking? How am I going to tell? Ma'am has so nicely explained open communication. Open communication is not charging somebody and saying, tell me why you have done it. That is not what is the role of a wife, nor a role of a husband. So here also the effective communication will help you to solve the question or solve the issues of your life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sasmita, for this answer. Next, Dr. Neha Jain. Okay. My this is from Swapnali, age 29. My husband and I haven't had any physical intimacy since I conceived. That is like 1 year of conception. And now my baby is around 9 months old. So it's around 19 months now. He in the beginning, he used to say that he doesn't feel right, and he like with respect to the surgery and her health. And now I have stopped feeding. He still finds excuses. He says that he has become spiritual, inclined towards spirituality, and he doesn't has that libido now. It's very embarrassing, but has my marriage come to an end? I also require intimacy. What should I do?
See, I know if your husband is saying this, so please go and, as ma'am said, healthy communication is needed. Though your husband is saying, though, so I'm going towards this and I'm going towards spiritualness and all, please go and talk to him that, okay, you have gone towards all these things, but I'm in a married life and I have my needs. And what should I do for all these kind of things? Until and unless, once you get a satisfying answer with that person, then you can go and get help from some professionals with your husband. Because yes, when you are living with your family, you have some duties with your towards your family. It never means ki, okay, you have bought them clothes, good articles, good thing, you have given them money, it's enough. There is a relationship of husband and wife, and that should be, if you are there in a family, you should fulfill all your duties towards your wife, and a wife should fulfill all her duties towards her husband. And all of a sudden, being in a family, when I'm taking care of your child, you cannot take all this decision on your own. There might be some other reason behind it, and might be the husband might be giving this excuse because of not 100%, but maybe some of the other reasons. If he is getting so much of spiritual, please try to find out why he is getting towards this kind of spirituality. What is the reason behind that? What is the deep, might be he must be feeling alone somewhere inside because of this 19 months of gap. So that is why, for fulfilling that gap, he has gone towards this thing where he's feeling that, okay, now I'm going towards this thing and it is satisfying me. If he is not going taking any initiative, go and talk to him, spend time with him, take initiative by your own self. And if you're not able to do that, if you are finding yourself that, okay, I am lacking behind, take help of some professional with this. Go with your husband so that a professional can explain this thing in a professional manner so that he may very easily understand all these things. But first of all, communicate with your husband that these are my needs and where I should go when I am in a family, when I am in a married life. I don't have any other option, and definitely no other lady have any other option. But along with other needs, this is also my need. Go for a healthy talk with your husband. That's okay.
Thank so you. We have very less time left. So very quickly, we'll take the few questions. Maybe just in 5-10 minutes, we'll wind up. Okay. Very quickly, Jyoti, like it's like around in 60 seconds now, whatever questions we have, we'll answer very quickly. Okay. My husband does not want me to work, wants me to take care of the baby full time. He thinks that parenting will be compromised if I start working. How should I make him understand? Very quickly.
Yes, sir. Sir, this is also a very common problem. Ye hamari society mein aisa hai ki hamesha the women have to step back in their career or they have to change, make changes in their life after the child comes in. So, what I usually suggest to my clients ki you have to convince your husband that you are capable of managing both. Again, effective communication, how good is your convincing power? And number two, like if you're working in a corporate and you get a baby and a family, definitely family is first and baby is your priority. Maybe you can switch to teaching or maybe you can do something online. So you're working as well as taking care of your family and maintaining a balance. You cannot have a very tough work life where you need to be touring or you need to be working on weekends. So you definitely need to be around the family, be with the child for a few years, and then you can go back to your high-flying careers. But it is completely an individual's choice. It is completely a decision between the husband and the wife, how they want to take it. And, you know, these are teething issues. Sir, I will quickly also mention about the previous question where you were asking, ma'am, regarding the husband not satisfying the conjugal needs. So, ye bhi hamesha mana gaya hai ki if there is a lacking in the wife, the husband can go to another woman. But if there is a lacking in the man, the woman just has to keep quiet and take it. But times are changing, women are changing, their habits are changing, and they are now equally responsible for the families. They are bread earners. So we are facing separation in every second home because there is a complete lack of patience and adjustment capabilities. So I request everybody who is facing issues on conjugal front, on husband-wife relationships, like we are getting a lot of queries on parenting and husband-wife relationship, that it is all in the mind. Please open up. You know, don't let your ego murder your relationship. Baat kariye. You will definitely come to a solution. And I'm sure that you will be solving your problems in a healthy and a happier way. Thank you.
Thank you. बहुत क्विकली सस्मिता जी, बहुत कम टाइम में अपने आप बंद हो जाएगा, नहीं तो सिर्फ 30 सेकंड्स टू 60 सेकंड्स में आप अपना पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दीजिए कि अ वाइफ सेज ओके इट्स या द सपना 39 ईयर ओल्ड ओके दैट शी केम टू नो रिसेंटली, उनको पता चला है कि बिफोर मैरिज हर हस्बैंड वाज अ वुमनाइजर हैविंग मल्टीपल अफेयर्स बट एट द टाइम ऑफ मैरिज ही डिड नॉट डिस्क्लोज दिस फैक्ट इवन व्हेन शी आस्क्ड. So what should I do? Should I quit the marriage, leave this man? She has a kid who is a 2-year-old kid. What should she do? How can she forgive? Very, very, very quickly.
Okay, so she, he, whatever he was in the past, we cannot change. Is he continuously doing that now? If not, then you don't have to forgive or anything because you were not there in his life. At that time.
The fact was not disclosed. What about this fact? The fact was not disclosed at the time.
Fact was not disclosed. Can we do anything for that? That is also past.
Okay. So we
when
can
we cannot do anything, then we should not murder the relationship for that.
fine.
And I want to add on to this. Please connect with marital issues. There are many, many marriage counselors are there. Yes. There are child issues counselors are there. Please open up and go for counseling. It is very essential for all of you. Those are going through all these issues.
Okay. Very quickly, Dr. Neha, बहुत quickly. Wife is not giving me space. Arjun 33, wife is not giving me space, always wants to be with me. Most of the time wants to talk with me, does not want to see my call, waiting, okay? Always checks on my phone, no private space, no personal space. What to do?
This means that somewhere or the other, your wife is feeling alone. Please try to search out the way, why, reason why she is doing so. Why she is doing so? Because somewhere she is feeling that I am alone. I am insecure. Try to remove all her insecurities. Definitely she is going to give you the space. उसको उसका पार्ट दे दो. यू जस्ट और नहीं आ रहा है उसको समझ में, कम्युनिकेट करो. सी आई एम डूइंग दिस 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 फॉर यू. उसके बोलने से पहले आप करिए. सो दैट शी इज विल ओके, आई एम गेनिंग इंपॉर्टेंस. आप चार काम कर रहे हो, पहले उसका काम करके दे दो. आप खाना खाने बैठ रहे हो, पहले उससे पूछे कि तुमने खाना खाया क्या. आप ऑफिस जा रहे हो, शी इज कॉलिंग यू, यू ट्राई टू कॉल हर ट्वाइस. अपने आप उसको समझ में आएगा. दिस इज ऑल बिकॉज शी इज फीलिंग दैट ओके माई हस्बैंड इज नॉट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ माई सेल्फ. वन शी इज गोइंग टू रियलाइज ओके माई हस्बैंड हैज स्टार्ट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ माई सेल्फ, शी विल नॉट थिंक अबाउट हरसेल्फ. डू व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू इन योर लाइफ. नाउ यू आर फ्री ऑफ इट.
मतलब गिव योर कोटा ऑफ रीअश्योरेंस एवरी नाउ एंड देन एंड इट कैन फिक्स थिंग्स.
यू शुड नो कि ओके शी इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ माई लाइफ, तो इसको भी मुझे इंपॉर्टेंस देनी है. आप अपने बॉस को भी दे रहे हो, अपने बच्चे को भी दे रहे हो, अपने पेरेंट्स को भी दे रहे हो, तो आपको उसको भी देनी चाहिए बिकॉज शी इज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ.
Right. Okay. Almost last question. I think it's okay. Jyoti ji, old age. दोनों अपने input दे सकते हैं. सस्मिता जी, ज्योति जी. Total हमारे पास 2 minutes है. Old age couple है, 65 year old के. Children abroad, stay abroad. Okay. Not much savings. They have very lonely. Not much communication with their children. Okay. Even health is not so great. What should we do to make our living life better? Till whatever time they are, how can we make it better?
So this is also one of the saddest part of our society, that we tend to forget what our elders have done for us. So in case they are having each other as a companion, that's great. You have each other. Aap log kuch ek aisi activity kar sakte hain for your own bonding, for your own health, going for walks, taking your healthy food, and you can do a small business. I mean, you can take up catering business where simple ghar ka bana hua khana. This is just an example. Or you can take up gardening, or you can guide
group,
people,
some group,
anything. Join a laughing club, because everybody is on their own journey. Your journey is yours alone, so you must take it to a good ending. And I'm sure that with your positivity that you are braving to come up with these questions, you will also find the solutions and be there for each other in a positive way.
Okay. So, Smita ji, 30 seconds.
So, I want to add up the gratitude.
30 seconds.
Yes, gratitude. Be thankful for what you have. You don't have good health, but you have good health. That is why you are able to write up all this and health.
And they have each other. They have each other.
Yes, they have each other.
That's a blessing.
Yes. Yes.
So be there in a positive way and help each other grow. Old together can be beautiful also.
Yes, having your life partner for a long time is a blessing in itself. Yes,
that is what I can say. Okay. So we have neared the end of this session. Still there are so many questions pending, but because of time constraint, we will take it up in another episode. And it was very nice on part of all our panelists, Ms. Jyoti Saproom, Dr. Neha Jain, Sasmita ji, that they have provided their valuable feedback, answers to the question, their own insight and their advices with respect to the problems were shared here. Thank you all of you once again for being a part of this webinar, and we will surely meet once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you
for having us. Thank you for organizing. Thank you so much.